Hey there, everyone. This is Netcat here, and I've been watching the Johnny Depp versus Amber Heard trial for a while. And recently, the expert witness for Amber Heard's side came on the stage and said some pretty bad things. And a lot of people were expecting her to be grilled by Johnny Depp's side on cross. And when that really didn't happen, there was a lot of questioning as to why. Well, I have an interesting theory about that that I would like to put forward. But first, that's going to require a little bit of explanation about the details of how this trial is being run. So, at the beginning of the trial, each side has been allotted 61 hours and 15 minutes. This includes their direct, cross-exam, and redirects. And they have been told that if they reach this limit, they will be stopped mid-witness, possibly mid-question. So, it is imperative that they do not run out of time while the other side has enough time remaining. So this is going to be important in a moment. Now, this expert witness by the name of Dr. Hughes was a psychologist who was testifying to all the bad things that happened to Amber. And almost everything that she had was coming directly from Amber or from other professionals who had talked to Amber, but nothing from Johnny Depp or from any other real analysis. So, how much time should really be spent in cross-examining her? Yes, they could have spent a ton of time just breaking her down, but then Amber Heard is going to get up on stage next and tell her story, and they'll have to spend the time to break her story apart as well. Now, think of this. All they really have to do to discredit Dr. Hughes is to discredit Amber Heard. So, why spend that much time discrediting Dr. Hughes when all they really have to do is go for Amber? And they definitely did a good job of doing that. Now, since they were certainly able to do that, look at all the time that they saved by not spending all of that time on Dr. Hughes. They got to spend it elsewhere. Now, this leaves us at the end of this current week where the plaintiff, Johnny's side, has 18 hours left going into the final week. And we have Amber Heard's side, the defense, having approximately 8 hours left. That gives Johnny Depp's side 10 extra hours that Amber Heard's side didn't have. This, in and of itself, I think warrants their decision. Now, this last part is a bit of a theory and a bit out there, but keep in mind that Amber Heard's team, whereas they may not be doing all that well in court, they have to be worth the amount of money that they're being paid for. So they have to be good in some areas. My thought is that they must be very good at trial strategy or other things beforehand. And I was thinking that Dr. Hughes might actually have been intended to suck time away from Johnny Depp's side by putting forth somebody who they could spend a lot of time just trying to discredit that they didn't need to, before they would have a chance to put Amber on the cross exam. I could be wrong there, but if I am, kudos to Johnny Depp's team for not taking the bait. So that's most of what I have to say on this. If you have any thoughts of this, go ahead and leave a comment on the video. Like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Well, have a good day. I hope you found this interesting.